We've gotten to know each other pretty well in the last few minutes. So here be the tale of woe that brought me down to the depths of what used to be the ocean.
Hell yes. Pirate backstory.
Great, I'm just gonna tune out for a minute.
I was the fiercest pirate captain on the fluttery seas. I had a fine ship, a loyal crew, and... I lost it all.
Wait, that's it? You didn't even explain the curse.
Oh, so me pirate backstory be insufficient for ye. Never mind then, ye scurvy cur.
Ha! See? She's got nothing. She always forgets the drunk character voice when she's scrambling for a decent motivation.
Unleash! Come closer. Whatever you're doing, it seems to be quite deadly, so keep doing that. Would you look at that? I'm all reloaded. Hold your applause, I've worked.
Yeah.
spell slots are all tingly. The depth, take you! I am not fit to wield such power. You didn't think I was empty, did you?
And yet, I am helpless.
What binds you, spirit?
Your kind stole my heart. It is more than I deserve. But my truest love, Yara, she pays the price which should be mine. If you would aid me, I would bid you to follow. Worshippers of the fell serpent Grisnesak have preyed upon the surface dwellers to feed their sacrificial rites since an age forgotten. And all that time, I've been here, not but aghast, unable to stop them. But I can be of some assistance. I will grant an ingress to their temple. Gaze now upon the fields of dead, victims of the coiled cultists.
What's he talking about? What dead?
My bad. Okay, there's lots of gravy stones. Like a lot. Like a lot, a lot. Like,
we get it.
Is a lot.
Wait a minute. Gravestones? This used to be the bottom of the ocean. How does that make any sense?
It's called scene setting, Valentini.
Based on your arsenal, I assume you will not blanch at your task. You must slay the coiled Tizox and retrieve the 5 pieces of Yara's voice shattered by the dark magic.
Her voice, yes, of course. But to what purpose?
They twist her angelic voice into a dark resonance which summons the fell serpent. Curse them. They befoul Yara's memory. And in doing so, they bind her soul to this mortal plane. I will not rest until she is free. That fateful day, Yara and I were enjoying a midday sail. She was singing me a song of such beauty that I nearly wept. But then, the sea roiled around us.
Ah, the blood tide rises! Breaking ground! No holding back!
Beware!
I have learned much and not yet nearly done. Recharge! Casting spells and loading ships!
It was a sudden storm of scale and claw. A cabal of wicked coils. And in a flash, they snatched my beloved from the deck, dragging her below. down, a fire of devotion in my veins. Then, just as I thought my strength would fail me, I grasp her hand. The treachery of the Tizox is ended. but this tale is not. Now, place the arcane devices upon the pedestals. And prepare yourself, for only through the crucible of Grisnasak's death will Yara's voice be mended. It comes.
Who calls me hence? You are not one of my servants. Unstoppable!
Have her soul bound in darkness, her voice riven from the weave of her spirit. But we will make it right. What is? Can you hear it?
What do you hear?
Her song. The last song she ever sang for me. It's even more beautiful than I remember. My dearest Yara, to my great and eternal shame, I could not save you in life. But even in death, I have not abandoned you. I only pray that my actions this day will finally grant you the peace which you have been wrongfully denied for so very long. Please. Make her whole again.
Orin, it is time to let go.
Yara, but I've only just gotten you back.
We can be together again, but you must let go.
As you wish, my love.
Have brought me.
Magic miscellaneous projectiles!
you can do a fellow.
First things first, head to the wreck of me ship, the Carolan. My one true love. Oh, aside from the sea, of course, but the sea's gone now, so I guess I have to shake with you.
Blasted Seymours! They're everywhere!
The sea's bounty is mine. Their harvest is my toy. And all that lies beneath the waves is mine.
That it may be, Chumberly, but I'm hard-pressed to spot any weeds about these sands.
Then face the jawsome wrath of my emissaries.
Well done, matey. There are three more tied up somewhere. Quickly now!
I am Chumberly, the Sea Jerk, Lady of Storms, and I will have vengeance.
I am now looking Queen of Puddles,
yeah!
Lady of the lowest tide ever seen by sailors' eyes.
No one plunders from me and lives. I have drowned mountains and drunk seas.
And I once caught a seagull with just behind the bootlaces. But you don't hear me boasting, do you?
I hold magic!
Boy, come back by, you toothy little bat! That's my big leg!
I'm all out of spell stuff!
managed, matey! That be a lot of them! Quicken back for your payment! You had it in ye. Now, proffer those pirated pearls, if you please.
Those pearls belong to me. Return them to my shrine, lest you earn my ire, mortal.
You have well earned these pearls. Now, for my payment.
You seek payment? I will show you the wages of your heresy, mortal, and redden my teeth on your heart's blood!
Arcane arrows! Yes, yes, rush to meet the darkness!
That'll be the last we see of her. You've rightly earned your payment, matey. Now, away with you. I've piratey things to contemplate, like what to do with these pearls.